Hey, buddy, it's Evicta. It's time for another Eat and Run here, the Binding of Isaac, Evicta Repentance Series. Happy Saturday, everybody out there. Hope your weekends have gone off to a great start. We've got ourselves a banger art of the day. It's actually the first ever slideshow of the day, sent in here by Camadeus A. Title thread was, made an AI do some upscaling of Sin's logo, and I'm just going to let this play for a little bit here, just so you can see these amazing renders done by an AI. I don't exactly know which program to credit for this, so definitely check these out on the Sinvicta subreddit, because they are amazing. That one right there is probably my favorite one, just because it kind of reminds me of Warframe, kind of reminds me of Attack on Titan. Very awesome indeed. Thank you very much, Camadeus. We're still waiting for the next video to cross 5,000 likes as we are going into the weekend, so hopefully we get that back on track here. And like I said, hope everyone had a great start to your brand new weekend here in the Mosh Pit. Really quickly, I should mention that we don't have, oh my god, we're starting with an R key. I don't have the external information mod playing because Isaac was having a tough time starting today, and I actually wanted to disable all the mods to make sure that that was not causing the problem. So that's the reason why you're not going to see for this video, but assuming the problem is fixed, it'll be back for tomorrow. C-Day's Echo Quebec 4-3 Kilo Golf Bravo Papa. We're starting with Portal and a little Portal, as well as a Golden Pill in the R key. Okay. Get taken straight to Monstro, so that's fun. We also only have 1 HP. Okay. Well, we got Power Pills. We also got an HP up. I think I did see us get a Tears up in there. So, yeah, we're already starting off to a wacky, wild, crazy run here. But, yeah, Isaac, for some odd reason, was having a difficulty. It was having difficulty starting up, and I found out, I think I know what the problem is. I'm pretty sure it's the video card driver. I just updated it. That's really the only thing that has changed from my system. So I rolled back the video card driver, and then it seems like everything's okay for now. But again, I wanted to make sure that everything is still kind of, like, you know, vanilla for now. So that's the reason why you're not going to be seeing the you're not going to be seeing the external information mod for this run only, but that's no big deal because we've always, like, not had the mod. I mean, I think we only started using the external information mod maybe a year and a half ago, something like that. Which, I guess, in the grand scheme of things, I mean, that is a long time ago for sure. But yeah. Now, as far as R key is going to restart the run, literally restart the run. Except we get to maintain any and all items that we've taken throughout the course of the run prior to that. So we basically just get to start brand new from basement one, except with the items that we've accrued over the course of the entire run. Now, there's a couple things that you can do with R key that is, I think, in one way, it's a good use, and the other way is a little bit more risky, a little bit more meme-y use, and that is going to be, go ahead and take the pill, that's fine. The smarter way, the way that I would say is the better, quote, better of the two, in my opinion anyway, is if you use the R key as a way to supplement the current items that you have. The meme-y way is to go for an Omega run, which we already did this past week, and I probably won't do today unless we just start really balling out of control here. So we also have Little Portal. Little Portal is going to basically hoover up four things on the ground. It doesn't matter what consumable it is. It could be pills, could be soul hearts, could be regular hearts, could be anything. And after that, it's going to create a portal, and that portal can do a variety of different things, like take you to the boss room, take you to the devil deal. It can drop out chests, that sort of thing, I think, anyway. It's going to have milk, which is not a fantastic item. And then we also got the old bandage, which is going to give us a good chance of producing a heart, a red heart, every time we take damage. Yeah. Very interesting, wonky start here. Milk is going to give us a big tears up every time we take damage as well. So we have a little bit of synergy going on when it comes to... Oh, there's the heart right there. When it comes to taking damage, we're just going to get blasted in the face by Gluttony. So you see our tears right now. 3.87. We can go ahead and grab all these hearts. Jokes on you, Gluttony. Not only did you give us a full heal, but you also gave us the devil deal on the next floor. What do you think about that? You saw that red heart... come out of nowhere when we got hit. That was from the old bandage, like I've just got done talking about. I could have let the little portal grab all those up, but I didn't want to do that because I don't want to waste hearts. Yeah, we got a couple of tallies on the like streak goal. Not for the last 2 days here, but again, the video, we have a couple videos that are skirting the lines there, skirting the lines of 5K. I do appreciate everybody out there who does goes through the routine of clicking the like button and leaving a comment every single day, of course. Got lots of comment streaks. Love reading the comments. Love reading all the different varieties, the variations of the comment streaks. Little portal also deals damage, by the way, which is actually something I didn't know. Yeah, it just goes straight through. It's like a piercing shot. It's like a piercing Bob's brain, kind of, except not as bad. Because obviously, little portal can't hurt you. Now, what would be cool is if little portal, if it dealt lethal damage to an enemy, is or like splitting damage, like if it caused like, you know, Envy to split like that. What would be cool is if it actually like sucked up the enemy in itself, and then that counted towards the portal. Ooh, man. Now, so far, this is definitely a run where Arky is going to have to be utilized for just an all-out, not re-roll, but redo of the run. Usually around the womb 1, womb 2 areas where you want to go for that. A little bit of a shimmy there by the torso. Now, I'm not going to stick with Shoop to Whoop, even though I would really like to. Shoop to Whoop is fantastic, although our base damage is just god-awful. We need the R key. The R key here is better used strategically than memingly. Memely? Something like that. There we go. The portal's still only one away from paying out here. I'm going to use Shoop to Whoop on the Gurgling Shoop to Whoop. Yeah, we got almost both of them. I didn't even see that creep there, so that's fun. Tropicamide, which is going to give us tier size and range up. Ooh, does little portal count as a sacrificable monster familiar? Okay, bandage. Hey. Again. Okay. Not fantastic, I would say. I will take Bloody Gust. I will try Sack Altar. Hey, it does work. Wow. Okay. All right. I can dig it. All right, so we got the nail, which is going to give us a slightly better survival rating. That's something that exists in the game, which it's not, because it will give us a half soul heart every time we use it. It will also give us the stompy effect, but also give us a speed down, but a damage up. Mom's contact, which gives us the very awesome freezing crowd control effect. So we need to go back and grab our R key. We could go into the shop to get more. Could get more HP here, but we have to bomb for it. Not entirely sure where our secret room is. I definitely want more HP. So I am gonna ding the donation machine here. Don't have to fight the spiders. You can walk out and walk back in, and they'll just simply despawn. So nice little trick to learn there. Okay, so. Definitely going to be using the R key strategically here to get us a better run. But for right now, we'll keep on going until it gets unbearable. I do really like those AI generator things. I realize that there's a whole bunch of them these days. And I've dabbled with them occasionally every now and then. Those of you follow me on Twitter, you know that I'd be posting them. Wow, can't believe we didn't have the damage to take that down. It's neat technology, is what I'll say. It is definitely neat. I think that combined with like the right amount of finagling and also just like mature. As the tech gets better and better and improves, I think that we're going to see some really, really cool stuff out there in the world of AI art. It's a neat concept. I mean, just like think about the technology involved for a second. You type anything that you want to see inside of a text field, and an AI generates that based off of what you've said, what you've typed. That's insane, man. Like, 20 years ago, we would have been like, what kind of Star Trek future tech are you talking about? There's no way that will ever exist. A computer that can create things of stuff that you just tell it to? That's blasphemy. And now it's like, yeah, that's just like, wait till you see these Snapchat filters. I never got on the Snapchat, never got on the TikToks or what do they call it? What's the other one? Not Instagram. What's the name of that there social media network that them kids are using all the time? I don't remember the name of it. It is hilarious to see people put those face filters to like movies and stuff. I didn't know I saw one of those videos out of context. Like I didn't know that it was like a filter, and it was scenes from Top Gun, from the original Top Gun. And the filter was like them doing like googly eyes, but also like sticking their tongues out in weird ways. And I was watching without sound, and I was like, what is, like, did someone re-edit this? What the heck is going on? And then I realized that it was a Snapchat filter, and I was like, oh, that's just awful, but also awfully hilarious. I love the dumb things that the internet can come up with. It is quite entertaining. We can go in here. Mystery gift wouldn't be bad. I wouldn't say no to another soul heart. We could definitely use it. Pick up Botfly, by the way, which is a fly familiar that will intercept incoming shots. Well, hypothetically incoming shots. You might be saying, well, what's the deal with that one versus the Psyfly? Well, Psyfly is just better in every which way. Botfly, while it does contribute to Beelzebub, it's not exactly, as I would say, reliable. Botfly tends to kind of have issues with taking down shots that aren't necessarily important and prioritizing those shots over the ones that actually matter, like the ones that are like coming directly for Isaac's face. Ikram might be here. It's the only place that seems logical for it. And I would not mind getting the mystery gift if at all possible. Please. Okay. Well, we got our bombs back. The cost of having to do a challenge room. Yeah, Botfly, you know, if you've got incoming shots, Botfly may stop one or two that are coming your way, but again, it's one of those things where you don't want to rely upon it. If you have to rely on Botfly to make a big time play, yeah, chances are you're probably in a lot of trouble as is. Oh yeah, and Botfly can't hit stuff that's above you either. But every now and then Botfly makes a big time play, I will admit. And it just makes the times that he actually does do a big time play all the sweeter. Because it's few and far between. Unlike Worm Buddy, who does make the big time plays. Okay, I have no idea where the secret room is. It could be in the elbow over here. Not there. I don't. It can't be there. I've already looked there, yeah. I don't know. Super secret room is here. You know what? I'm just going to go buy our soul heart and, yeah. Why couldn't we get this steel chest over here? Ah, that's why. Grab the soul heart so we at least have a chance of getting a devil deal here. We definitely need more damage. Abaddon was a good start. Yeah, we get the freeze on little Gertie. Oh, Gertie Jr., I mean. For another freeze here soon. The cooldown should be up. Here we go. There you go. Mom's contact again, just so good. And we get an HP upgrade. All right. This gives us item rooms if we go down to Shoal, which right now I'm not really thinking we're going to, but we have no other trinket to pick, so might as well. I'm waiting till we get to the point where, like, we have the technology to create games. Like, it just makes a game that we're talking about. Just threaten the entire gaming industry at that point. You know, that's one thing that I really enjoyed about AI Dungeon, which, by the way, I spoke about it maybe a couple months ago, but if you haven't seen my AI Dungeon video, I really, really think that you would enjoy it. Highly recommend it. Because it's peak my humor, but also, like, wildly entertaining for those of you who are a big fan of that game. I get, and even then, like, I don't even know it's a game at that point, because the things that you can do, like, it's wherever your imagination takes you. It's the world's most craziest, like, freeform D&D session that you've ever done. I have to go check it out. Someone in the comments will link it down below, I'm sure. Mr. Boom. Mr. Boom gives us a free Mr. Mega Bomb, which we probably won't use. I mean, I could... I don't think that the secret room is there, but... It's a free use, so it's only going to cost us a little bit of time. We were sort of catching up to the boss rush, but I don't think it's going to. I don't think it's going to matter. Oh! As soon as I walked out of that room, I knew I was going to do it. All right, brain. You know what? You deserve every bit of that damage. That's what you get for not paying attention. There's another one over here. All right. This floor is just filled with good stuff. More damage, more tears. We did get a movement speed up and a tears up buff from Bloody Gust. Which is going to trigger again every time we take damage, we're going to get something good happening. Now that was a case right there of Botfly not prioritizing a shot that I thought it was going to, instead just being distracted by the turrets, as you see right here. All right, so we have almost maxed out movement speed here. Gotta take down the little one. You can't go for the champion. And a dead end. All right. All right. Secret room should be to the right of here. Should be is the key word. Okay. Radar's not off that bad. Get a hero font card. All right. Super secret room should be to the left of here. Should be. Doing this just because basically the bomb is free and we also get an increased devil deal chance. I say the bomb is free because it's not guaranteed that you're going to get the soul or the 5 cents from there, but it's almost guaranteed. Almost. Be frail. I look forward to the day where I can say, hey, this is the type of game I want to see. And then an AI generator just makes the game. Completely bug-free and gives you full legal right to sell it and make copies of. Don't copy that floppy. What is that game? Okay. All right. All right. You never know what that crazy freezing effect is going to do, apparently. All right. Going to turn all these into keys here.
Ace of spades.
Keys are no longer a problem. And we get goat head as well as twisted pear. Of course, we're going to take both of these. Yeah. That genuinely made me mad. You got to be careful with the freezing crowd control effect because it's just like the fear effect, man. Like this game is so sketchy that like you don't know what the game's going to do. You know, like you fear something and it goes like through a wall and then like it just moves at like 4 billion miles an hour. You can't trust Isaac. Don't ever trust Isaac. An Emperor card here. Movement speed. Wish that it was back to Bloody Gust levels, which we're well on our way to getting there. Thank goodness we got that Eternal Heart, because we'd be on a half heart right now. Twisted Pear is a big help for us, of course, giving us the two familiars that are going to double our shots, but it does they do deal reduced damage for these shots. Still very good, though. They gain all benefits of the tier effects and whatnot. They're just good familiars. Would have been nice to get Pandora's box, but we wouldn't have taken it past that floor because obviously our key. And yeah, this is an absolute, I would say almost necessity that we use our key to get just a better run here. Now this is not a reroll. Those of you who've never seen this item before, it's not a reroll. It literally starts the run over. So we go all the way back to floor one, essentially. And I'm probably going to do it, honestly, maybe even after this floor, because we just cannot stop taking damage. I'm going to take the champion's belt to give us more damage here in hopes that we can get some kind of momentum going. Love to get that soul heart if we can. Now remember, we don't have to worry about... We don't have to worry about losing the devil deal because we've got goat head now. But that doesn't mean we want to take damage. Okay, we got one down. So where the fear shot of Abaddon is going to really help us out here. Where the counterpoint is that the freezing shot of Mom's contact is not going to help us. It's actually hindering us right now. All right. Plenty of keys. I know that the secret room is there. Apparently, I just don't know anything today. What day is it? Today is Saturday, right? Those little swinging motion that I'm doing back and forth like this, what I'm essentially do is I'm pushing the tiers to get a little bit more range out of the shots. That's designed to help us kind of eke out a little bit more damage at a range that we probably shouldn't be able to hit without doing that little trick. That's something you could do in base Isaac too, so. Room is usually pretty terrifying, but we've got the benefit of our range as well as our freezing shots. Okay. All right. Looking for that item room. Wild card here. The wild card would be useful if we... You know what we could do? We could use the wild card for a second R key. That is a possibility. Bro. Woo! All right, D Bizzle, let's get it going. D Bizzle, here we go. Yeah, starting it off right, son. Yeah, we're using the R key on this floor. 100% using it on this floor. Thank you, Dark Bum. Appreciate it, son. Keep it going. And I'm even tempted to use the wild card after the R key. After like three or four floors more on the next run. Can't get that. All right, let's see if we can survive through this fight. Of course, it's gonna be bloat. It's probably gonna be champion bloat because we've got champion belt. Great shot by Botfly and great shot by bloat. Kill him at Dark Bum. Oh man, I would love to get. I'd love to get both of these, but we just can't. So I'm gonna take the pact. Oh, never mind, we can't because we got Leviathan. Let's go. And then we can get into the curse room for free, which then we can use the R key for and get out by using the R key without incurring any damage. All right. Things are starting to look up. Everything's coming up Millhouse here. All we needed to do was be pushed to the brink of death. I'm going to grab this free key. We're going to go in here and see that there's nothing in here. And then we're going to rip the R key. All right. So as you see there, it's same exact seed. Echo Quebec 4-3. Kilo Golf Bravo Papa. Now, as long as I don't use anything else, including a space bar item here, I can get a second R key from Wildcard. So So notice that the timer has not reset though. So boss rush and old Hushy and blah blah blah, all that stuff is out the window at this point. But we don't care. Right now we're looking just to get some kind of better run than the first. Even though technically this is still the first run. This time around we've got D-Bizzle. We've got Twisted Pear. Lots of damage here. Leviathan transformation coming up clutch. See, that would be a shot that you would expect Botfly to shoot. We can't take PhD because, I mean, we can take PhD, but we can't take pills because then that ruins our wild card R key, and I'd rather not spend 15 cents for just no reason at all. This is one of the few times where not taking PhD is fine. If our intent is to use the wild card as an R key to get another run behind this. Here we go. We get Glass Eye. D-Bizzle is not paying out. And we're going to head on down. Here we go again. I don't even know what this run is anymore. We've turned it into a good run. No. Okay, Darkbum, you've not paid out with a single one. We need to go through the pep talk again here. I will stop this game and speak to you, son. I need to see way more hustle out of you, because right now we're not seeing it. Right now this is like Detroit Lions hustle right now, which is none. There you go. I want to see that, but like times like a million. Big Chub. She's big and she's chubby. Big Chub going to be a familiar that flies in a very straight and very slow arc. Well, not arc, but line. And she will damage everything, including blocking shots that get in her way. She does deal a pretty decent amount of damage, I will say that, but it's unreliable just because of just how slow she is. RD Bizzle. The payout, right? So unless we get HP here, we will not be able to take a devil deal. Bizzle gives us the full card. So that was Big Chub. We finally get a Tears up here. We can't not take Vengeful Spirit. Which is unfortunate, but that's just the way the mop flops. All right. So I have to we'll get another Tears upgrade. Beautiful. Love it. I've got to remind myself that I need to not accidentally use anything, just all willy-nilly style. And I also have to remind myself not to use what we have currently, because obviously we're going to restart the run, and I don't want to do that yet. But we built up quite the... I'm not going to take Metronome because, A, I'll forget that I've got R-Key queued up, and B, I mean, I like Metronome, but not in this spot. Treasure map, I'm down with that. Treasure map's going to show us the entirety of the map, but not show us the locations of things, just shows us the map itself. I have a feeling the boss is going to be down to the southwest. Good chest there. Oh, baby, look at that. Explosion of HP here. Oh, Oh, what am I doing? Already found it. That's all we had to do. We just had to threaten. We just had to threaten Dark Bum with a coach's speech. We get HP, and yep. There's the unknown again. We know we have, I think, two. I'm pretty sure that we have two red hearts. I want to say we have no bombs. We got the curse room. Then we get a little bit of a movement speed buff, a little bit of a tears up. That's from Bloody Gust. If we had rock bottom, hint, hint, wink, wink, we wouldn't be losing those stats at all. Yeah, we don't have any bombs. Well, I'll take Game Breaking Bug. Maybe we can reroll this into a bomb. The world card, which I don't want to use because we have the wild card. Remember, we still have the R key queued up. I'm gonna look really stupid if I ended up using something after the R key and just didn't realize it. Which is that? I mean, that to be honest, that's definitely something a thing that I would do. You get a bomb. I want to go back into the item room and go grab that tinted rock. We did not have an access to that one right there. Another soul heart. It's always worth it to even if you have only one bomb and you know that you don't need it anywhere else of importance, it's always good to use your bombs to try to get a soul heart. So there's another tinted rock right there. Soul hearts are always going to be good. And we get red stew. And red stew is definitely a possibility here. Now, I don't think red stew resets if you use an R key. I don't see why it would. But we're going to buy it. I'm not going to buy the Bible because, again, R key. I'm not going to take the soul of Azazel. There is a crawl space underneath here, though. And, yep. I guess we could touch the Book of Revelations. We could also touch the Bible as well. Try to get Bookworm. Wasting our red stew buff though. Now obviously this is not going to be like the other run which we had, which was just amazing synergies with Toxic Shock as well as red stew. I mean that seriously was one of the coolest synergies I've ever seen. We get an angel deal. And we get the wafer. I guess that makes sense. Since we restarted, we haven't taken a devil deal, so it would make more sense that we did get an angel deal there. A bit surprised by that. And Curse of the XL. Well, if there was ever a case to be made to use an R key, I'd say that would definitely be it. So because we have Goathead, we're guaranteed to have lost one angel deal or devil deal due to the presence of the Curse of the XL. There's our other one. Soul Locket. Soul Locket's going to give us stats every time we pick up a soul heart. So it kind of works like Candy Heart in a way where you literally just get stats for picking up soul hearts. That's it. So it's minimal stats. I wouldn't say that Soul Locket is anything. It's not like Keeper Sack. I mean, it is like Keeper Sack in a way that it gives you random stats for like spending stuff or picking up stuff. But it's not like Keeper Sack as in like the quality of stat ups that you get. I'm wondering what I'm doing here. I'm just looking for the item room. Which is not over here. Alright. So that, to me, tells me that the item rooms are either adjacent to one another or they're right next to the boss room. And it's looking more and more like they are adjacent to one another. First chariot card. Again, not something that we're going to be using. Yep. There. Going to be... Let's see. One's got to be up here. This has to be one of the item rooms up here. No, it's not. Yeah, they hid both of the item rooms next to the boss on this run, on this seed. That's pretty insane. I mean, look at the size of this depth is the size of like 3/4 of the void. That's how big this map is. Finally find our first item room here. And a few steps down, we do find our second one. And it's just like I said, right adjacent to the boss item or the boss room. So we do get infestation 2, which is good. Infestation 2 is going to give us a blue spider every time we kill something with our tears. Be like that. So it just adds a whole lot of value, but also adds a whole lot of DPS to your build. We'll take car battery here, even though we're not planning on using anything anytime soon. Same thing goes for Diplopia. Restock. Half price restock, I mean, sure. Black candle would have been nice, but we don't have money for it. So our red stew buff is still ticking. I would love for this red stew buff to at least finish this map and the next. Maybe. Definitely want the shot speed up. Thank you, D-Bizzle. Here we go. Take the negative for the damage up. We're still rolling. What's the AI generator of your choice? I would like to know. Maybe there's some out there that I haven't seen or heard of yet that I need to. I've made some pretty cool stuff. I've never shared them on like social media or anything like that. But I've generated some pretty neat things. I've also generated some pretty nightmarish, ghoulish figures that were unintentional. Like the time that I forget the name of it. It's one of the most common ones. It begins with a D. I asked that one to make Darth Vader as Hulk Hogan, or Hulk Hogan as Darth Vader. That did not go well. And then I learned from Ryan that apparently that program itself is designed to deliberately make the eyes look all screwed up and scary. I guess the free version it's a way to get people to pay for it or something. I don't know. I think it's kind of lame. I think that there's going to be people who aren't going to pay for anything no matter what. It doesn't matter how good or how bad or how honorable you think they're going to do. But at the same time, I do tend to err to the side of believing that people are inherently going to do the right thing. Not always, not all people, of course, but you know, I think that if something is good enough, people will pay for it. They recognize it's like music. Like, I mean, that's the philosophy behind my band, and not, you know, I don't want to charge anything for my music because I'm like, yeah. I think the people who want to support something like that, they will. Same thing goes for Patreon, you know. People are generous enough, and we do have plenty of generosity in the mosh pit. I don't actually want to go with Spirit Sword. Spirit Sword's fun, but I think that this build is better with Death's Touch. The boss, I don't know if it's going to be all the way to the north. I feel like it's not. There was a tinted rock in that last room. Right there. Actually gonna lose this bone heart because I don't want it. Yeah, I've never charged for my music. The album's totally free. You can even find it on YouTube if you want. It's literally on my channel. And it's literally free. And people have paid for it. Many people have paid varying degrees of money for the album. Most don't pay a whole lot of money, admittedly, but some people do. Some people give a whole... They're very, very generous in the mosh pit, which is not to be, like... That's not a surprise to anyone, especially me. I know how generous everyone is out there. You get the Bookworm transformation, we're going to head on Dizown. Got a supersized Saturday run for you. If you're enjoying this run, everyone, make sure you click the like button. If you're feeling generous, that is. Doesn't require any money from you. It only takes less than a second and is a great help to the channel. Would appreciate it. We're trying to hit 5,000 likes on these videos so we can add more to the like streak counter, which hasn't been a streak for a while, but people are still saying that they're seeing their likes or seeing the recommendations getting removed from YouTube, so I don't know at this point what to do. YouTube, I do have a contact at YouTube who has looked into it and is actively monitoring stuff on the channel. But unfortunately they are not like an engineer or anything. I wish I had that level of access. But yeah, if you want to help out, contribute, all you gotta do is click the like button. And you'll see more videos like this on your sub feed from me. I appreciate it. And I thank you very much for it. I've had some very generous people buy the album. We've had some people buy the streamer package as well, which I've never actively promoted here on the channel. I don't promote really anything on the channel. Mark and I, we did remix a version of our album that is what I coined the streamer package. And essentially what that is it is an instrumental remix version of our album designed specifically for people who want to use it for videos and streams, like for background noise and whatnot. So there's no vocals in there. It's all instrumental. And it's all copyright, DMCA free, all that kind of good stuff. Because I'm the one who owns the copyright. And no one will claim those videos. And if they are claiming those videos, I need to know, because I need to go after that you know what. So, but that one we do charge money for, because we did have to pay Zeus, who's our producer. We did have to pay him the studio fees and the remix fees, which was a hefty amount of money. And just trying to recoup that cost. And we've had many people buy the streamer package. Many people have made videos with it, and they've sent it to me, and they've emailed stuff to me, and I love it. That's the whole point of it. I love about music, man. Music, it transcends and entertains to a different degree than videos do. People consume music differently than videos, obviously. Augatory, doing work. Look at that, canceling out all those lamb shots. I tell you what. Down goes Lamb. Oh, yeah, we're going to do a victory lap. Second run, Victor Lima, Whiskey, Yankee 8, Mike, Delta, Delta. Now, theoretically, we should still have that R key built up and built in. Obviously, Red Stew is long, long gone. Red Stew definitely served its purpose. Oh, man. Inner Eye is going to kill our tears rate, but give us a whole lot more tears. And Inner Eye plus Twisted Pair means that we're just going to be destroying things. gonna be so many Psys flying around, like, you just, it's gonna make you spin your pretty little heads. And we get money equals power, head on down. Now the goal here is to try to get to, we gotta do Boss Rush, we gotta do Isaac, we gotta do Blue Baby, gotta do Mega Stand, we gotta do Delirium. All in this run. If we want to have a chance for an Omega, which I'm still not really like trying to go for an Omega, but you know, we can try. Oddly enough, we found the boss room before we found the shop or the item room, which is very, very, very weird, strange, and also like is a pure indicator of the fact that they are going to be adjacent from one another. Oh, you know what? I can't use a bomb because I can't use the remote detonator because that's going to override Sissy! How you doing, Sissy? It doesn't even matter what we were talking about. We got little Sissy. Sissy! I also have spectral tears, which is the reason why you're seeing our tears go through rocks and stuff. Here you go, D-Bizzle. I apologize. Little Sissy, how you doing? It's been too long. Far too long, little Sissy. And like, I don't know how long it's been, but it feels like it's been forever since we've seen Sissy. Our damage is going up, not because of Red Stew or anything like that, but it's because of money equals power. Again, I'm going to look real stupid if I ended up accidentally or inadvertently using something that cancels out the R key. I will also freely admit that I don't know if R key persists through victory laps and R key, and not R keys, but victory laps and, well, yeah, R keys. I'm not sure if the wild card is going to preserve it or not. Oh, we got to get rid of the stupid. Yeah, we got to get rid of this remote detonator. We have to use bombs. I'm gonna buy Pandora's box, but I'm not gonna use it. Go D Bizzle. How you doing, Sissy? We missed you. We still keep getting devil deals, which is not what we want. I don't want to have to use a sacrifice room to get our keys for Mega Stan. And we do have to get Mega Stan. But if we have to, we have to. You D-Bizzle, appreciate it. As you see here, this is just rolling. Rolling Scythe death here. Which would not make... That wouldn't actually make a good band name, but I think that'd make a great, like... That'd make a great, like, monster truck name. Oh, this is not the item room as I thought it was. In my lifetime, I have gone to one and exactly one monster truck rally, and I thought it was the dumbest thing that I've ever seen. And this was like me as a kid. Like, I thought, I was like, what on earth is the purpose of this? And for some odd reason, the only thing I could think of at the time was just how much gas or fuel. I don't know if there's gas. It might be diesel for all I know. I don't know. Was how much fuel these giant monstrosity machines were like consuming. I was like, for what purpose? What is the purpose of this? To impress like drunk people, I guess. Get Hive Mind, which is going to give a spider Babby, and as you saw right there, instantly made all of our spiders bigger, which means they're going to deal more damage. Get Get a tiers up here, bar of soap, although we are tiers capped. I mean, I know we need the angel statue keys, but come on. The hope here now is that we get enough soul hearts to, or red hearts to facilitate just using sac rooms, because one sac room and we get enough HP to, if we get enough HP, we'll be able to get both of the keys that we need. Or we can just ignore the Omega run. Something else that should be brought up is that we have the wafer. I don't think the wafer... Does the wafer mitigate the full heart cost of the sac room? This is something that I probably have known in the past, but I've since long forgotten it in the sands of time. The sands of bad memory. We're going to lose a little bit of damage here that's from losing the Horror of Babylon buff. Then we're getting Stigmata, which is going to give us another damage up and HP up. So we definitely now have sufficient amount of HP to play a sacrifice room in full. If we find one. Soul Lazarus. Probably not going to use the Soul Lazarus. Probably don't need it. I hope not anyway. Hey. Look at that. We get the Mind as well. Okay. Uriel was just invisible. I forgot that because we have the Act of Contrition, That essentially means that we don't have to worry about Devil Deal Prestant because it overrides that. And since we have the Goat Head, that's going to give us a guaranteed either Devil or Angel Deal. That's why it shows 50-50. Right now we're leaning more towards Angel Deal, of course, because we have the key now. We can knock out a lot here. We can knock out a lot here in this one run. Assuming that we get the other key piece. That's the big thing. We have to bank on us getting another angel deal, which nothing is guaranteed in this game. Perusing around. I know that there's no sac room here because obviously we have the mine, so that shows us the entire map. No guesswork involved. Not need the blue map. Oh my god. I'm sorry if it's bothering you that I'm not looking at these tarot cards, but again, there's no reason for us to because we've still got the R-key queued up with wild card. Which we'll use after Delirium, assuming that we don't get Mega Stand blocked. Okay, so this time we take the Polaroid. We're going to ignore the Void Portal. I'll take Dead Dove just because of the... There's no reason not to take it, let's put it that way. E-piece... Now we got to go do boss rush, which is not going to be a problem. Spider bite, Roid Rage, host hat. I'll take host hat for the anti explosions. Yeah, we are. This is chunkage right here. I think that was blast assist. That was definitely bloat. Lighted over him. Sissy's up there charming him. Good job, Sissy. See you making the big time plays, girl. Fallen just died without splitting, so there's that. Oh, black brown head, bam to bam. Oh, black brown head, bam to bam. A red dingle and red mega fatty. My God. We'll say we haven't talked about it in a while, but I do still really love the custom sprites for all the champion bosses and stuff. It really added a lot to the game. And I don't mean in the literal sense that it added, yeah, of course it added more art and stuff like further, but you know what I mean? Like it makes the game feel more complete, you know? Get X-ray vision, and we'll head on down after I grab my soul heart. Now we're getting to the point where, like, I'm really, really hoping that we haven't used anything that overrode our key for wild card. Telling myself just don't do anything stupid. Like use the wild card or use anything else. The range upgrade here. We would have gotten another angel statue. We get Uncle Holy Water. Uncle Holy Water making a splash here on this mega size Saturday run. Which started out real bad. On top of like not great stats, really was. I mean, we were taking all kinds of bad damage, admittedly. So, but we definitely turned it around, and this is our reward for doing so. Get rewarded with a very awesome and very unique run. Not that our key runs aren't unique, of course, because obviously we've had like probably a dozen of them now by now. But we've never had an our key run with a second our key baked into a wild card. It's happened before, but never like at the start of a run, if that makes sense. Cliff of Balance as well. We gotta go see old Hushy. Had fun on the Star Wars Finest Break. And if you missed out on it, definitely stay tuned. If you are, I mean, join our Discord. Like, the Mosh Pit Discord is a great place to be. I make a lot of, like, announcements and stuff in there and announce, like, all kinds of events and stuff. It's a good place. This is a good place to be. Chariot card. No. Oh, you know what? Endless Nameless. If we end up an Omega run is still possible. If we get a payout from Endless Nameless after we use the wild card in Delirium, we will have an Omega run. That would be the most wildest, insane thing to happen. What the hell just happened there? What is going on? Did our hitbox move like 30 feet in front of us or something? On top of everything else, how did Hush make contact with us? We weren't even near him. Anyway. We would have to have Endless Nameless pay out with Wild Card But I don't know if it would carry over after using an R key or not. That's the thing. I don't know if it would just stay in Delirium's room. Hotfly, this is where you're a Viking. Thank God we got past that hush fight. It was close. That would be absolute insanity if Endless Nameless somehow pays out. Many things have to go right for that to happen. We have to have Mega Stand not freeze us and end the run. B, we have to make sure that Endless Nameless procs. And C, we have to hope that somehow, if it does proc, that the wild card that it would produce would go with us to the next level. Or to the next run, I mean. Whenever we get hit, the intruder will appear, and essentially Isaac loses his head. Makes him infinitely more difficult to see on the screen. Not as difficult as if we had Guillotine, though. Ooh, you know, oh man, but we can't do it. I was gonna say what we could do is we could use Pandora's box, but Pandora's box does not give a payout in the chest. I think it gives one penny. Twinkie and Kamikaze, no thank you. See if we get a Delirium portal, not that it matters, from Blue Baby. Don't get Delirium portal, so now it comes down to that age-old stopping block, Vol Omega runs. Which is, will Mega Stan allow us to continue to Delirium? Find out. I hope he does. I want to see if this wild card Endless Nameless thing will happen. I would love to know. Now, we don't have overwhelming damage. 14.77 it's a good amount of damage to be sure, but it's not like face meltingly like we don't care, you know, we can't be touched damage, you know what I mean? It's still good, don't get me wrong. I saw you, Gluttony. Gotta be all sneaky over there. Okay. Gonna be the biggest tease of the year if we end up not being able to go to Delirium. So you just think about what you're gonna do here, Stanley. Thank you, Pogatory, clearing out all those shots. And survey says... Oh, baby! All right. Here we go. I'd say if that one, if that little, that little surprise didn't get a like from you, I don't know what will. I'm pretty pogged right now. Go straight to delirium here. And now the moment of truth. A, did I accidentally use anything and didn't remember it? And B, if we didn't do that, will our key still be active? C, will wild card be doubled by Endless Nameless? And D, will it actually come with us to the next run? All these questions will be answered momentarily. As Delirium got absolutely mollywopped in here. Down goes Delirium, and here we go. We ended up saving it, but we did not get the payoff for Endless Nameless. That's fine. That's fine. Same seed, Victor, Lima, Whiskey, Yankee, 8, Mike, Delta, Delta. Obviously the same seed. So now we have an option and a possibility because we've gone through a lot of items here. We have a chance of seeing Death Certificate show up and or Genesis in an angel deal. So another thing that I'm thinking about doing is I'm thinking of still not using any consumables and getting another wild card, which would absolutely be insane if that happens. So now here's another thing. Remember, we have restock. Oh man, Birthright. Birthright didn't give us anything. I'll take meat for damage. Champion Bell for damage. We have restock, so there's a chance that we could see a wild card here. Yeah, but I'm not going to spend that much money. Full of Isaac. Okay. Lots of half-price tarot cards here. Ooh, okay, okay. Now, we didn't get a wild card, but we did get a judgment card. So now, that could be an even easier way of getting another R key or death certificate. Because what we need to do now is we need to use Pandora's box inside of a secret room on floor 4? Looking it up real quick since we don't have the mod. Platinum God at co.uk. Want two boss items. That's womb 1. That's womb 1. I don't know what the equivalent of that is here, but that might be our best shot unless if we find a wild card in a store or something like that. Oh, it's Curse of the Blind. Black Candle would have been real nice. Because that's something that we won't be able to do, is if it is Curse of the Blind, we're going to have to wait. Wooden Spoon. Sulfur. Sack Dagger. Yeah, I don't know what the... it's a funny game. I don't know what the equivalent is for Womb. Now, to be safe, we can also just go regular path. And if we did that... Lost contact. No treatment gives us. We lost some shot speed, but that's fine. We get Bloody Lust. Well, Dark Prince's Crown, hooray. Okay, let's go back and get our knife pieces. Knife piece. So, yeah, another thing that we could do is theoretically. We could get the elusive. Sacrifice Room in Corpse 2. But that one is a little bit less reliable. Should be picking up this money. Not only for money was power, but also because we may need to be buying more cards here. Actually, you know what? Yeah. Fragmented card, you can come play because you give us a chance for another item pedestal inside of a secret room. So there's still a strong possibility that it might happen. Strong possibility. All right, we went back up here because I don't feel like going in the mines, and we don't have to be in the mines until the next one. Don't freak out. That's why we don't take blind items in secret rooms, kids. So, I mean, right there, that is an item. And we are on Flooded Caves 2, which I think might be another item. Apologies for the alt tab here. Case one. Yeah, it is another item. So we could just do it now. We could rip this now, rip the judgment card, and hope that we get it. So the wild card is no more. Lich Crown. Gonna take a risk with Glitch Crown. There she be. He's done it. Oh, baby. Who knew that we were going to be living in an Omega Run world today on this Saturday? Calculated risks paid off at the end. We're going to get Black Candle hopefully here. Take Black Candle so we eliminate the possibility of Curse the Blind. Not that it matters, of course, now. Oh, baby. We even passed up rock bottom. Oh, man. Not today. So those of you who don't remember, I think the last two times that I had a chance to get Sacred Heart with Glitch Crown, I accidentally passed it. I didn't accidentally pass, I just kind of goofed the landing. Not today. Not today. We are on point. No idea what hit me, but oh man. Happy to do it. Happy to do it. I really wasn't, I was not feeling an Omega run. When I saw the R key, I was like, all right, let's try to see if we can do an R key run. But, you know, depending on how bad it goes, maybe we probably won't be doing this. But then the wild card happened. And then I started getting that tingly feeling. Like, you know what? We might be able to make this happen. Because I know that everyone likes watching the Omega runs. Get some people excited to click that like button. Now I'm loving it. Our tears rate's so bad. A yeet mom over here, and then we're just gonna run as fast as we humanly can. We Isaacly can. Even see that fly there. Okay, come back up here. Feels good, man. Feels good. To turn a run that didn't go all that well in the start to turn it into an Omega run is truly satisfying. I'm all for it. However you make the game fun is what I say at the end of the day. Oh, Lilith. Ain't got no worries at all, sissy. Let your troubles melt away, sissy. We knew it was going to be a blessed run because we had Sissy here. I will take Sacred Orb. For S's and G's. Not that it's going to matter, of course. We're barely taking any items at this point. Also, I just realized I went down to the depths. Oops. We can't go. We have to use a sacrifice room to get back up there. Because my exuberance, they got the better of me. All right, we can still do a, if we have to, we can go do a victory lap. I mean, we have to do a victory lap now at this point. You know, got Guppy's eye. We'll just take the negative again, I guess. Yeah, so now we have to do a victory lap. Sorry about that, everybody. Hey, there's a sacrifice room. Although the sacrifice room, honestly, is probably like... I mean, yeah, I know that we have the Ankh, but I don't necessarily want to use it. We can just go fight Lamb again. It's fine. Be doubly sure that Lamb is dead. I think this gives us Spun. And, yeah, I'm not gonna do that. We do get a Yara rune as well. Thankfully, we can see the entire map, so we can just fly straight to... Like, we don't have Mercurius, of course, but, like, we almost have Mercurius, just because our damage is so dang high. I'm gonna peruse. There's the backpack in there. School bag. Should probably let D-Bizzle grab a couple hearts here just in case. Ended rock is actually hidden up here. If I didn't come down this way, you would never seen that tinted rock. And Shielded Tears is really doing a number on these projectiles. Obviously, we've already beaten Old Hushy, so we don't need to go fight him again. Oh, man. Grab some soul hearts. Maybe I can actually place the bombs in the right spot. So Sacred Heart Godheads, it's going to be a lot of damage. Yep. Seeing if I had not gone down here, we also would not have gotten Godhead. So let's go try that again, shall we? This time I won't be a dummy and just be super excited and actually go in the right path. Just kind of highlight one of the more annoyances about repentance, though. The whole, like, you got to go a certain path. Otherwise, it's just one and done. Otherwise, your run is basically just over. Unless if you have the ability to do a victory lap, yada, yada, yada. I'm not trying to absolve myself of the mistake that I made. I'm just saying. It delayed our... Okay. Oh, yeah. That's right. We got to be careful of item pedestals. Which means for that school bag, we may have been able to get, like, rock bottom or something. Not that we need it, of course, but... All right, let's try that one again. Sorry about that. Exceed. Papa 3, Juliet Whiskey. Lima Tango 7, Juliet. I actually don't want Kidney Stone. Big age nails. I definitely don't want Cricket's body. Take the stapler just for the damage. And this time we're going to go alt path and we're going to stay on alt path. Synth oil, no big deal. We already had the damage. We already had synth oil. Already got spun. Wicked crown. Oh man. Cricket's head. Yeah, just 72 damage. It's okay. A decent amount of damage. It's a respectable amount, I would say. Bingo, bango, bombo. Papa's got a bumbo. I mean, Star of Bethlehem, I guess. Not that we're ever going to need it, because, like, we're just gonna fly right by it. Oh man, look at the brightness of Godhead. Lover's card, yeah, that would give us more. I don't even know what it would. Oh, this removes one of our heart containers. Sure. There is Binge Eater. But I won't take Binge Eater. I know that people getting sick of Binge Eater, and we already had one this week, so that's fine. SI. We'll get the Halo here. Oh, swing and a miss. A little late on that. The only reason why I'm checking inside of the secret rooms is just because I'm just curious to see if we can find, like, rock bottom or something. Obviously, we don't need it. It would just be funny if we got it. There we go. There's Genesis, but we do not want Genesis. Take Immaculate Heart. That's an extra 14 damage, you know. Spoonbender. Definitely take. Yeah, this is Mines 1, right? Yep. Okay. It was just a little 10-minute side tour. No big deal. I mean, look at all the extra items we got. And if you can't see what's going on right now, trust me, you ain't alone. Hey, Great Gideon, but if Great Gideon was made of just balls of light of death. I don't really understand how anything's still alive at this point. There we go. Squeezy here. That would be Guppy if we can get it. And we do get Guppy. All right, now we can go over here. See, no problem. We got Guppy. Not that we needed Guppy, of course. This is the time just to have fun, you know? That evil F word. Not that one, the other one. We don't really need anything. This is definitely going to be the fastest mother kill that you ever done seen. Yeah, we don't really need that. Like, mother is not going to live very long. And I think that old beastie is also going to die even faster. I do want to see what this planetarium is down here, because I'm hoping maybe it's Mercurius. There's Mercurius. Oh, baby. All right, now the big question is, would we have gotten, if we didn't get the R key, would we have gotten a way to get out of there anyway? We get rock bottom anyway. All right. So we now have 141 damage. Pretty good. Pretty good. And, yeah, I think we'll take another Sacred Heart. Gives us range. Hey, what do we want here? Oh, man, Deadeye. Well, I mean, I didn't get Deadeye. And the game crashed. Yay, Isaac. Well done. Well done. It only took an hour and 35 minutes. Now, you can't blame that on mods, because I literally have no mods running right now. That's just Isaac being Isaac. So I think we lose. I think we have to get Mercurius and we have to get Rock Bottom again. Which honestly, I think that's actually a bad idea. I'm going to skip both because Rock Bottom is going to make that happen every single time. And yeah. And I don't even think I bring up the console. Oh, I can. That's right. In Afterbirth Plus, you had to have mods present in order for you to have be able to get to the developer console. But in Repentance, you can just do it through the config file. All right, so we're just gonna ignore boss rush. No reason for it. All right, got a stars card. Sure, whatever. We don't need that Yara rune anyway. But yes, we would have gotten Rock Bottom, but the game becomes incredibly unstable. When you're talking about this much damage. Which is odd because, like, we don't even have the usual suspects of, like, Jacob's Ladder, Jacob's Ladder, Trisagion. Trisagion would not be smart here. I don't get it. Trisagion usually causes the problems as well. Okay, we would have not gotten a sacrifice room, so the buck would have stopped there. Had we lost our wild card and or didn't get another R key. But thankfully, we got our death certificate. We would have been able to get out of the mother fight. Yeah, this is going to be a record-setting mother kill. She's dead. All right, now we use our death certificate. And as long as you don't bung up this part here, I require silence. Silence from the peanut gallery. Silence, please. To concentrate. There she be. One more R key. Here we go. Feels good, man. Feels good, even after a little bit of a goof there. I think Ipecac would actually also crash the game, so I'm just gonna ignore it. We don't need any more items. I don't want to make the game any more unstable because I don't want to get into a loop like we did on that one Omega run where I had to fight Beast like 30 times because the game just kept on crashing. And eventually what I had to do is I had to go into the console and start removing items. And I really hate doing that because the game should just run as programmed, you know? Like, we didn't do anything game-breaking in here that the game wasn't already doing. Oh, my Lord. Okay, C-section might be a bad idea, but I'm going to do it anyway. Okay, let's see what these look like, and let's see if it crashes the game instantly. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. I do want Mercurius, so if we can actually get Mercurius, that'd be great. There it is again. He's done it. Look at that. We only missed one item pedestal for the entire run. So Mercurius is going to allow us to just run right through doors that we don't have to clear rooms at. Not that we were having problems clearing levels anyway, but this just makes things even more streamlined. I don't... Oh my god. Sure. We're going to be doing so much damage, the game is not going to know how to process it. I was going to take Eden's Blessing, but you probably shouldn't take any of these, to be honest. And I realize that some people would be like, oh, come on, just take the items, blah, blah. But no, you have no idea. When the game crashes, it will lock you into a run and not let you out when you're fighting Beast. And I really, truly do not want to have to go into the developer console and remove items. Again. Coupon would be pretty fun. We had a space bar item, which we don't. There we go. We got Deadeye now. It's the pact again. There we go. We go on to old Beastie. And old Beastie is not long for this world. I don't know if all the Arky malarkey and all the victory lap stuff, I don't know if that has screwed up with Dad's note. That tends to happen. So we'll just see. But there has been times where I had to actually give myself Dad's note because the game soft locks. So hopefully that's not the case here, but you know, who freaking knows at this point. The Soul Heart here from Black Canada. Okay, it's still there. Good. Woo! Omega run.
Benton, it's gone. Just get over it.
What do you mean it's gone?
Check out these blind items here. Might as well. Oh, man. Well. We were blessed by Little Sissy for this entire run. No. Take Contagion, although that may result in a game break.
He's self-destructive and disturbed just like his father. Look at who he has to look up to.
Crack the Skizzle. That's the beauty of Mercurius here, is that we don't have to fight these. We don't have to fight any fight that we don't want to. Zyvlar! What? They spawned a chest in front of there. That was rude. It'd be Elzebub. I'll never do that again, game. Don't ever interrupt me and my Zyvlar. Did that explosion go through all of those doors? He's mascara is going to kill our tears rate, but give us 190 additional damage, you know, as you do. Yeah. I don't know what monster's long. It would take us like 2 years in order to fire a tear. The cack. I mean, we have host hat, but like, I'm pretty sure that would also make it to where we were gonna. It would take us forever to fire a tier. I just don't want to do that. No. I want to see what this damage can do without like totally destroying our ability to play the game. Which, I mean, we're not gonna have to play the game, obviously, but there we go. Let's see what we can get out of our lost child. Nothing. All right. Well, you know what's happening. You know what's happening. Now, I'm not saying that we're going to be able to get, like, an actual suplex on Beastie. Because she may die before we're even able to do anything. Yeah, Dogma's already dead. Well, hell of a run, everyone. All I gotta say is thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this run, click the like button. I mean, how could you not? It's Saturday. What a way to kick off the weekend of just not being able to see anything and just seeing bigger and bigger babies fly across your screen. I don't know what's going on. I think war is dead. Death apparently spawned. Yeah, we're not going to be able to get a suplex, I don't think. And let's see how long Beastie lasts. All right. I don't know if she spawned or not. And she's dead. Thank you. And the game crashed. Yay. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. I think that run is over and officially ended. I don't know for sure. Nope. We gotta do that again, huh? Isaac. Well, it was so good, you get to see it twice. I don't know how I'm supposed to stop the game from crashing because, like, I'm not firing. I guess I could stop firing after a certain point, but, I mean, who wants to do that? So maybe when Beastie spawns, I'll stop firing after we kill Death. Okay. I'm holding off firing. I'm backing away. I'm not firing. Literally not firing. Still not firing. Okay. Maybe I can use bombs. Oh. Crack the skizzle. There we go. All right, bomb, and she's dead. Hey, the game didn't crash. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. And again, thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. Happy Saturday. I'm going to go rest my voice. Take care, everyone, and until next time, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Cole Rhodes, David Scott, Ty Kirk, Willow of the Wisps, and Kaizo Blades. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find by going to the link down below or by going to patreon.com/Sinvicta.